So I'm here with Mr. Brown and Mr. Williams from Sweet Energy Fitness. And Mr. Brown, how has it been today?
Well, it has been awesome, to be honest. Really awesome.
So Mr. Williams, what do you think, how was it, I mean, actually introducing to the students another occupation apart from the doctor, the lawyer, and the teacher?
I mean, it was very interesting. I think most of the kids were like drawn to it based on the different type of stuff that they were taught today, based on not only just like just getting up, doing up, running from back and forth, stuff like that. We also incorporated songs, which I think they found very interesting, songs with movements, which they all love. So yeah, it was a really good.
My name is Vaughn Claude Larmon.
Carrie Ann Blake.
I'm Kelly Segren.
And I'm Tiana Fairman. And we are from
Boylston Vocational Training Center,
a little but a Talawa institution.
The reason we're here today is to showcase our skills to the student of the
Jessie Ripoll Primary School.
From Boylston Housekeeping, and our reason here today, we are doing a towel folding. Yes, we work in the hospitality industry where we fold towels, making the hotel beds and stuff like that.
To fill in the blanks for me. When I grow up, I would like to be a
doctor.
Why would you like to be a doctor?
Because I want to help sick people.
All right, thank you so much. Very good. Hi, Rahana. So you told me earlier that you wanted to be a surgeon. Can you tell me who inspired you to become a surgeon?
Actually, no one really inspired me. I just saw a lot of people dying and I really felt sorry.
And what do you think you'd have to do in order to become a surgeon?
Study hard, work hard, achieve it.
Very good, excellent. All right, Deshane, fill in the blanks for me. When I grow up, I would like to be a?
Dancer and a footballer.
You'd like to be a footballer? Mm. Who's your favorite footballer?
Cristiano Ronaldo.
Cristiano Ronaldo. And what do you think Cristiano Ronaldo had to do to become a professional footballer?
Work hard and put your mindset to what you want to do in life.
Have you been doing that?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm a career development officer just to speak with the students from Jessie Ripoll, enlightening them about their goal setting and how it would impact their lives, what their challenges would be like moving forward from PEP going into the high school.
Mary.
All right, Naomi, filling in the blanks. When I grow up, I would like to be a?
Wife.
You'd like to be a midwife. Who inspired you to want to become a midwife?
No one.
So what is it about a midwife that you're excited to become?
Babies.
You love babies. All right, so what do you think you have to do in order to become a midwife? Have you researched, done any research on who a midwife is, what you have to do?
Study about midwives and all those things and how to deliver babies and do work in a school and all those things.
So have you started?
Mm-hmm.
What have you done so far?
Work. I look on YouTube and I watch them deliver the babies. And
you watch them deliver babies? And that doesn't scare you? Well, I'm so happy to hear that. Very good. Hi, what's your name?
My name is Mark Hill.
Who would you like to become in the future?
A biologist.
And who is a biologist?
A biologist is a person that like studies on plants and animals.
So what inspired you to want to become a biologist?
Well, since I love animals, I don't want to know more about them.
Know more about them. Very good. All right. Hi, Nathaniel. What are you from?
6G.
Nice. And can you fill in the blanks for me? When I grow up, I would like to become a?
Military doctor.
Interesting. What inspired you to want to become a military doctor?
My parents are both soldiers and I would like to also follow in their footsteps and also help people. So, for example, during World War, I would like to help the sick and injured.
I'm Carolyn Peck from the Med Service. I'm a meteorologist and we're here at Jessie Ripoll today, Career Day, to inform our students about weather and climate.
This is a rain gauge. This is also a rain gauge. There are two different types, right? This measures rainfall. So everything that is measured here is displayed on this screen.
This is very important because weather and climate affects everyone every day, all times of the year, and as such we are expected to keep informed. So we need to teach our students about this so they can impart it to their parents and their other siblings so that everybody can be aware of what is happening in the weather.
I'm Javon Bruce.
So Javon, what class are you from?
6B.
And fill in the blanks for me. When I grow up, I would like to become a?
An astrologist.
That's impressive. Who is an astrologist?
An astrologist is a person who studies space.
And you have a love for space?
Yes, miss.
So who inspired you to want to become an astrologist? You don't hear a lot of children saying they want to be an astrologist. So who inspired you?
No one really. I just wanted to be an astrologist myself.
Hi, tell me your name.
My name is Jaden Ricketts.
All right, Jaden, what class are you from?
6B.
So, Jaden, who would you like to be in the future?
A footballer.
Nice. Who is your favorite footballer?
Messi.
Messi. So, what makes Messi your favorite?
Because he's really skillful. He can play and he's smart in doing football.
So, do you think Messi needed school to become a footballer?
Yes.
So are you still working are you still studying?
Yes, miss.
Show me some of your football skills. Shelly, how has it been?
Wow. Well, the first thing is it has been a long, long, long time since I've been on this compound. This is my This is my alma mater. I used to be here with a lot of fun memories. So walking through the gate and, you know, seeing what we know it as, which is the Benny Shell. A whole lot of fun. One, I didn't expect the great reception from the students today. And I mean, some of them even know me just by saying you are from, you know, and saying to them, you know, I dance with the great Orville Hall, that's why I'm dancing Dynamite. But the day has been an exceptional day. I would do this again any day. And I'm always here, I'm always open. Dance is my life and it is what I do. I run a dance studio, I own a dance company from dancing. So I tell them, let nobody tell you that you cannot become what you want to become. Let nobody deter you from becoming who you want to become.
Excellent. And I mean, even with the younger generation, how did you feel inspiring them to be something other than a traditional doctor, lawyer?
You know, the minds are young, so you have to influence them from now. And you know, just saying, speaking with them on, you know, a one-on-one level, being down on their level, trying to understand them as youngsters, it was a little tricky because, you know, them, the mind, them attention span all over the place. But once the dancing started, into it and all these things, but they understood quite well. And
you're looking forward to seeing more dancers. More dancers in the future.
There are no more words. There are no words to explain. I mean, it's been a while since I've done, like, even done a talk like this at any one of my schools, whether it be high school, primary school, or college. And I'm just overwhelmed. I'm really overwhelmed.
Well, thank you again, Auntie Shelley, for spending the day with us. And we do look forward to seeing you again.